What is up and what is good, Park people? It is your host with the most, Paul Cantu, coming at you guys once again with a tutorial video. So if you're like me, you guys are into the thrifting game. You may have been walking through a thrift store at least once or twice in your life and seen that dope pair of red pants, that super awesome pair of camo pants, or maybe some crazy flannel pants that you were just like, these is mine. But then when you try them on, or when you just hold them and look at them from afar, you're like, these are baggy as all get out. To illustrate the point, I got the most ridiculous pair of pants of all time. I got the Coogis from like 2004, back when FUBU shirts was in. And I'm gonna actually turn these super baggy pants into skinny jeans. So if I can turn this ridiculous pair of baggy pants into skinny jeans, you can too. So we're gonna go from bagtastic to swagtastic in this tutorial. So without further ado, I'm gonna throw these on right now, show you just how baggy they are, and then get into the supplies you'll need in the tutorial itself. Let's do it. So these are actually the pants on the brother, and you can see how big these things actually are and how baggy they are. Like, there's honestly almost no recovery from pants being this baggy. And they're actually a little bit baggy in the waist, and you typically wouldn't have pants that fit your waist exactly right, but I just had to cop these because they're so ridiculous. I mean, look at the booty on them, the stupid booty design. It looks like I have a huge indention on my butt with these pants. But yeah, these things are super baggy, as you can see. And if you're not rocking the 04 FUBU shirts with these or some 3XL tees, then they just aren't gonna work. So let's get into the supplies you'll need and actually get into turning these bad boys into skinny jeans. Here we go.
All right, so sexy voiceover is initiated. The first supply you're gonna need, of course, is that pair of baggy pants. In this case, of course, I have the infamous Coogi pants. You're also gonna need a pair of pants that fit you well and skinny. You're also gonna need some scissors. In this case, I have some nice pink ones. Look at that, sexy. You're gonna need a pen or pencil as well. And then you're also gonna need a sewing machine. In this case, I have a Stone Age sewing machine with some blue thread. So just have a sewing machine and some thread at hand. All right, so the first step is you wanna turn your pants inside out. As you can see, I already did that and I laid them nice and tight on the table. The next step is you're gonna wanna get your nice pair of good fitting pants, so your ideal pair of pants, and lay them on top of the baggy pants. All right, so once again, you're gonna wanna make sure that the seams line up, especially along the crotchal area and along the inseam of the pants. So just go ahead and make sure that both pants are aligned, nice and flattened out. As you can see, I'm just ensuring perfection in every step right here. But yeah, just go ahead, lay them out nice and sexy, then get your pen or pencil and trace around your pair of skinny jeans. So as you can see right now, I'm just going ahead and tracing. I'm moving back and forth. Don't really worry about using a pen or pencil. Just don't use a Sharpie or any like writing utensil that'll bleed through the fabric. But a pen is perfectly fine. In this case, it's definitely easier for me to see. So as you can see, I'm just going ahead and doing the exact same thing on the other pant leg right there. And now here comes the sewing part. So basically all you're gonna do with the sewing machine is just follow the line that you drew. Just follow the straight line that you drew. And as you can see, there's a third hand bobbing in and out. That of course is my mother. So she's just ensuring that her young pup is nice and secure with that sewing machine and is doing his thing on it, which I am. What's up? Holla at me, Coogi. But yeah, if you guys don't know how to use a sewing machine, find an able-bodied family member who can show you how. It honestly is pretty easy and self-explanatory. And once again, I got these pants from a thrift store, so don't hold any pair of pants too sacred. But yeah, just go ahead and do that to the very end of the pants, and then you're gonna do the same on the other pant leg. Look at that, finishing it up. All right, then you're gonna get your pair of scissors and cut along the seam that you just sewed. As you can see, I'm doing it super quick and super speedy. But yeah, just go ahead and cut off that extra fabric which results in the pants being baggy. And you essentially, in this step, create the skinny jeans. So you're just cutting off that excess fabric. And as you can see, there's a lot of embroidery on these pants, which I would typically advise you guys to definitely shy away from, because it does make the job a bit more difficult. So then the next step is simply just turn the pants right side out, and then you're pretty much done. So as you can see, in this case, I'm just pulling the pants right side out, right chill. Look at that Coogi. Got that Coogi booty all over, son. What's up, boy? Gonna be flossing in the club tonight. FUBU shirt. All right, so as you can see, the pants are nice and right side out. About to lay them down right and tight and just show you guys the overall look of them. So of course, look at that, almost had no wash on them pants, just striped blue, what's up? But yeah, as you can see, they're pretty much done. And once again, I highly recommend that you get some pants in your waist size at the get-go. These were a little bit bigger, so I had to kind of stop at the beginning of the pants. But as you can see, the embroidery is still there, still looking sexy. Now I'm gonna show you guys the full fit, huh? Coogi.
Throw that ass in a circle, you know. Throw that ass in a circle, circle. Riding around like a merry-go-round. If you throw it back, I might hurt you. Hurt you. Toot it up, girl, there you go.